Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here with a Photoshop public service announcement. If you've ever touched the eraser tool when you're editing in Photoshop, you're doing it wrong. Whenever I get the chance, I try to promote non-destructive editing, the ability to make an edit in Photoshop, but easily reverse it later on if you have to. Today's video is going to show you how you can erase non-destructively using layer masks. Let me show you how this works. So here I have a document that contains two layers. In this case, my goal is to remove the background of the top layer, leaving only the subject in the foreground so you can see the background layer. Now, beginning Photoshop users will usually go straight for the eraser tool, as that's the tool that makes the most sense to those just starting out. Let's look at why this is a terrible idea. When I start erasing the background of this image, it certainly seems like it's doing what we want it to do. But just like using an eraser in traditional art, this process is very destructive. At this point, if the document is saved and closed, everything you erased is lost. So unless you have a duplicate of that layer when the document is opened up again, there's no easy way to bring back that data. On the flip side, there's a much more efficient way to erase or hide parts of your layers. Using the same layer as an example, instead of grabbing the dreadful eraser, we're going to be actually using a layer mask instead. To add a layer mask to one of your layers, you can click on the Add Layer Mask icon at the bottom of your Layers panel. This will place a white box beside the layer's thumbnail. Now, the reason that the layer mask is white is because the basic rule of thumb is that white is visible while black is hidden. So now, instead of erasing, we're actually going to be brushing, either with a black or a white brush. As I paint black on the layer mask, I'm seeing the exact same result that I saw when I used the eraser. So what's the difference? Well, this time nothing is being destructively removed. Instead, you're actually hiding parts of your layer, which can be easily brought back by switching over to a white brush and then painting on the area you want to reveal. There's also another big advantage of using layer masks. If you've ever tried to use the eraser on a smart object, or an adjustment layer, or even a vector shape, you've likely seen a warning that tells you that the layer is not directly editable, and it must be rasterized, which isn't the smartest move. Rasterizing a smart object or a vector shape destroys the original properties, which defeats the purpose of using one of those layers to begin with. With layer masks, you can simply add a mask to any type of layer, and just like we did a moment ago, you can hide portions of that layer with black or reveal them with white. And this again is completely non-destructive. So if you want to grab the eraser tool in Photoshop, next time you go for it, visualize me smacking your hand as you move your cursor across the screen to your tools bar. Just don't do it. I honestly can't think of a good reason why you should be using the eraser rather than using layer masks, unless you're a traditional digital painter and you only work on one layer, and some people still do. As always, thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos. Make sure to check out my website, iceflowstudios.com. And now make sure to follow me on Google+. Nathaniel from tutvid.com and I are doing a weekly Google+ hangout where we're going to have all sorts of guests. Last week, we had Jared Poland from Frono's Photo. This week, we have Justin Seeley from lynda.com. And who knows who we're going to have next week. Take care.